huts of history's pains, our ancestors bled and died. But with strength and with power we overcame, to restore Virgin Islands' pride. To preserve the beauty we devised a plan, to obtain ownership of your precious land. Educating your people is the golden key to maintain the success of this territory. Oh, how radiant are your daughters, and how wealthy are your sons. Your beaches boast your beauty, and your success is second to none. Our hopes and pride. Oh, beautiful Virgin Islands, your qualities can never be denied.
Excellency, Governor John J. Rankin, CMG, Premier and Minister of Finance, Dr. the Honorable Natalia Wheatley, Deputy Governor, Mr. David Archer Jr., Pastor Winston Salmon, staff of the Governor's Office, senior staff in the Civil Registry and Passport Office, staff of GIS, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon. First, I give thanks and praise to the Almighty God for waking us up and bringing us here this afternoon. Today is indeed a momentous occasion for the 49 recipients of British Overseas Territory citizenship, their families, friends, and invited guests. I greet everyone gathered here today with a warm BVI welcome to you, you, and especially you. I would like to go to the book of all books for inspiration, and today I choose Ephesians chapter 2, verses 19, and it reads, "So then you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God. It is in this vein that I said to you, the recipients, that you are no longer strangers and aliens, but fellow citizens of this beautiful territory, the Virgin Islands, more widely known as the BVI. I now offer my sincere congratulations to all the recipients of British Overseas Territory Citizenship, BOTC. Please join me in applauding them on their achievement today. Thank you. I will take a moment to expound on your most recent accomplishment. Naturalization is a process under the British Nationality Act 1981 by which persons such as yourselves become citizens of the territory of the Virgin Islands. As citizens of the Virgin Islands, it confers on you certain rights. For example, you are now eligible to apply for a BOTC passport, commonly referred to as a BVI passport. You would also be eligible to travel to the US Virgin Islands on your BOTC passport without having to obtain a US visa or a visa waiver. You may be eligible to obtain a United States visa waiver, which would allow you to travel to the US mainland without applying for a US visa. You have the right to register to become a British citizen of the United Kingdom, following which you may apply to hold a British passport. Having a British passport enables you to travel to the United Kingdom for work, leisure, study, or play without the need for permission to do so. Now that we have dealt with the benefits, permit me to remind you of your obligations as our most recent citizens and ambassadors of these Virgin Islands. You will be expected to favorably represent the territory in your behavior, communication, and action. May I remind you of your civic duties, that you be subject to your rulers, those in authority over you, to be obedient citizens, serving your communities, and the less fortunate amongst you. I implore you to become useful citizens by joining a civic or community organization. In swearing your oath, you swore loyalty to our new king, Charles III. As moral citizens, how you relate to government and God is imperative. We must render unto Caesar what is Caesar, and unto God the things that are God's, according to Matthew 22, verses 2. Before I go, it would be remiss of me if I did not thank some persons here today. His Excellency the Governor, John J. Rankin, CMG, our Premier, Dr. the Honorable Natalia Wheatley, Deputy Governor, Mr. David Archer Jr., Permanent Secretary, Mrs. Charlene Dabrio-Letsam, Pastor Winston Salmon, GIS, the committed staff of the Governor's Office, and of course, my dedicated staff, who also assisted in making this ceremony a success. Once again, as I conclude, congratulations to you, our latest members of BVI's citizenry. I urge you to be exceptional British Overseas Territory citizens wherever you go and in whatever you do. A gentle reminder to those of you receiving certificates of naturalization, please remember to keep it in a safe place and please do not laminate it. Thank you and may God bless you all. At this time, Governor will address the new British Overseas Territory citizens, followed by a musical selection by Mr. Kyle Moses. Welcome, Governor.
Honorable Premier, Deputy Governor, Registrar General, Pastor Winston, ladies and gentlemen, it's a real pleasure for me as Governor to be with you this afternoon and to have the task of presenting to you your certificates of naturalization. 46 of you here today who have made your homes here in the Virgin Islands. Today is your day, and I hope that you're all feeling a sense of fulfillment, of satisfaction, and humility as you attain your British Overseas Territories citizenship status. I say humility because this is an event where you're all committing yourselves to new ties, ties which will stay with you for the rest of your life. The British Virgin Islands, this beautiful territory in which we all have the privilege to live, attracts interest from outside because of the opportunities it provides. Some people come and stay only for a short period and then leave. But others, such as yourselves, choose to remain and to contribute productively to the community you've joined. And in due time, the opportunity arises, as it has today, to be naturalised in your new place of abode. And so, from so many different backgrounds and nations, you've come together this afternoon to jointly take on your new citizenship. And to my mind, this is a really enriching process from which the BVI as a territory gains. The intermingling of cultures, different ways of thinking, different knowledge, different skills, brings with it clear and tangible benefits to the community as a whole. But while those different experiences are important and enriching, every society also needs some shared essential values. So, this afternoon, you're being asked to recite the Oath of Allegiance and Pledge of Loyalty to His Majesty King Charles III as your sovereign and to the British Virgin Islands as a place you've chosen as your home, respecting its rights, freedoms, and democratic values. This is a solemn pledge as you embrace your new citizenship and the opportunities it offers. The shared values of which I speak also include respect and concern for others less fortunate than yourselves, or simply those who are in some way seen as different. Perhaps when you first came here, you felt different. But as the good book reminds us, you shall love the stranger, for you were once strangers in this land. All of you have demonstrated a commitment to the Virgin Islands over many years in your individual fields of activity. As Governor, I encourage you to maintain that commitment going forward and not lose sight of the responsibilities we all share to our families and to wider society. I also take this opportunity to thank all those who have helped to get you to this day, including your friends and family, the Registrar General and her team, and all the staff of my office. I congratulate each and every one of you, and as you receive your certificates and recite the oaths, I ask you to reflect on the opportunities and responsibilities of your new country of citizenship and your responsibilities to your fellow countrymen and women that today's event represents. Thank you.
you for that beautiful selection, Mr. Moses. Let's give him another round of applause. I would like to welcome His Excellency the Governor to present the new recipients with their certificates of naturalization. Please come forward as your name is called. Mrs. Marie Popo Andrew. Mr. Alfred Anthony August. Mr. Jean Delise Averill. Mr. Israel Bahador. Ms. Saskia Barnes. Mrs. Katie Ann Bell. Sir Richard Branson. Mr. Angel Brown Valdez. Mr. Raphael Brown. Mrs. Dolores Valdez de Brown. Mrs. Natasha Pollard Butler. Mr. Kenister Charles. Miss Ella Christopher. Mr. Cyrus Claxton. Mr. Alfonso Davis. Mr. Junior Douglas. Mrs. Katie Barnwell Edwards. Mm-hmm. Mrs. Chandani Foy. Mr. Antonio Ferreira. Mrs. Burnett Glasgow. Miss Tiffany Grant. Miss Arlene Harris. Mrs. Herlene Hazel. Mrs. Karen Howell. Mr. Nigel Howell. Yes. Mr. Dave Jardine. Mr. Mark Jeffers. Miss Zoe Joseph. Mrs. Monique John Latchman. Mrs. Yvonne Mackenzie Manning. Mrs. Kamala Patti Malayal. Mr. Ravindra Mewalal. Miss Karen McLeod. Miss Sharon Mitchell. Mr. Everton Morgan. Mrs. Renell Jones Phipps. Mrs. Edna Prophet. Ms. Parbati Ragnath. Ms. Saren Samuel. Mr. Nestor Ramirez Santana. Mrs. Barbara Pinnock Smith. Mrs. Rosalind Card Smith. Mr. Hicksford Tydale. Mrs. Ahelia Turnbull. Miss Gladys Walters. Last but not least, Miss Judith Williams. Thank you, Governor. A warm congratulations again to all the recipients of British Overseas Territories citizenship. I now invite the Honorable Premier to give remarks. Premier?
Your Excellency, the Governor, Deputy Governor, Registrar General, Pastor Salmon, all other persons are part of the Governor's team and the Registrar General's team, and all of you who have gathered here for this very important occasion. It is with great pride that I stand here, and I want to thank His Excellency for always inviting me to be a part of these ceremonies. It's certainly a pleasure for me to be here with so many familiar faces, persons who I went to school with, persons who I serve in service organizations with, persons who I've gone to church with, persons who I've worked with, and so many other persons who I've interacted with for one reason or another. And you certainly have been entrenched in this community and have been making your contribution. And it is certainly a proud day for you, and it's a proud day for me to welcome you to the, officially, I should say, to the Virgin Islands family. There'll be some persons who would see the diversity of our community as something negative. Some persons who seek to divide us, whether by race, or whether by religion, whether by place of birth, or some other reason they seek to divide us. But I call on you to be champions of unity in our community. For what really binds us together are not all of those things I just mentioned. What really binds us together is love for these Virgin Islands, our commitment to preserve our environment, our commitment to defend our values, our commitment to lend a helping hand where it is needed in our community, our commitment to build these Virgin Islands to be the best that it can be. And certainly, I call on you to really epitomize that principle that really the BVI is really worth all of us protecting it and defending it. And sometimes persons, when they get to this point, they say they got their papers. And I will say to you, it is not just a matter of getting your papers. You have become a part of a family. And regardless of your place of origin, we want you to see the BVI as home. No, we are not looking to replace your place of birth or origin. We don't expect you to replace it. But we want you to elevate the status of the Virgin Islands in your heart and in your minds. And while sometimes persons feel unwelcome here, I want you to know that there are many of us who embrace you. Embrace you as brothers, embrace you as sisters, embrace you as part of the Virgin Islands family. And I'll make reference to the second verse of O Beautiful Virgin Islands, the territorial song, that for me really sums it up well. It says, "We shall protect your bountiful shores and uphold your dignity. We shall fight to preserve your culture, your splendor and integrity. And we shall never fail to understand how blessed we are to possess this land. So we shall unite standing proud and tall. Let none divide us lest we fall." And I did watch with interest as many of you sang along with the territorial song, and I saw the pride in your eyes as you sang. And certainly, I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate you and to applaud you on taking this very important step, and to remind you that as citizens, we have work to continue to do, because of course you have already begun the work. You haven't just been here and you haven't just been working in your jobs and collecting a check. You have already been contributing to the fabric of this society. And we just ask that you continue along that path so that we can build the Virgin Islands to be the best that it can be. I also want to recognize the governor who has announced that he'll be retiring. And certainly he has, I'm not sure how many more ceremonies that you'll be doing, but I certainly think we should give the governor a round of applause for the (clears throat) really for the role that he has played in this process and ensuring that you have a efficient and effective process for receiving your BOTC status. And Governor, while every now and again we have a little slight disagreement, I want to let you know it's been my joy to work with you, especially in settings such as these, on important occasions when we're able to confer the status on deserving applicants. So again, I say to you, it is a very joyful day in the Virgin Islands in welcoming you, and we, you know, pray that you continue going from strength to strength on your journey here in the Virgin Islands. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Premier. We will now have the affirmation of oaths. I would like to ask the new British citizen, overseas territory citizens, to please stand and repeat your affirmation of allegiance to His Majesty the King and the pledge of loyalty to the Virgin Islands after me while raising your right hands. We will recite the Pledge of Loyalty. I give my loyalty, to the Virgin Islands, and respect its rights and freedoms. I will uphold its democratic values. I would observe its laws faithfully and fulfill my duties and obligations as a British overseas territories citizen. We will now recite the affirmation, the oath of allegiance. I do solemnly and sincerely affirm that on becoming a British overseas territory citizen, I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty, King Charles III, his heirs and successors, according to law. Thank you. You may be seated. We have come to the end of a very short ceremony. As we close, I would like to extend best wishes to all of you and once again congratulate you on your achievement today. I ask that you kindly stand once more as the governor departs. Thank you all. Our new British citizens, you are asked to assemble outside on the stairs for a group photo op. Thank you so much, and God bless. Congratulations.